Hi, good morning students. Today we are discussing about the second year chemistry. The name of the chapter is solution. In this solution, the very important question is relative lowering vapor pressure. How is that related to the molar mass of solute? The definition and the first question is the relative lowering vapor pressure and how is that useful to determine the molar mass of a solute. First, the definition of relative lowering of vapor pressure. The ratio of the lowering vapor pressure of the solution to the vapor pressure of pure solvent is known as relative lowering of vapor pressure. The mathematical formula is the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the P naught minus Ps by P naught. These are also written as the relative lowering vapor pressure is equal to the delta P by delta, P naught zero or P naught. Next. It is useful to the relationship between relative lowering vapor pressure and molar mass of solute. Molar mass is also called molecular weight. According to Raoult's law, the relative lowering vapor pressure of a dilute solution of non-volatile solute is equal to the mole fraction of solute. That is, the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of solute. It can be written as also P naught minus Ps by P naught. Then mole fraction is, what is the mole fraction? The definition of mole fraction is the number of moles of one component and to the total number of moles of all components is called mole fraction. So X is equal to Ns by Ns plus N naught. In a very dilute solution, the number of moles of solute will be less than the number of moles of solvent. Hence the Ns is neglected or denominator can be neglected. P naught minus Ps by P naught is equal to Ns by N naught. In this solution, the number of moles of solute is very less than number of moles of solvent. So it can be written as also P naught minus Ps by P naught. It is equal to the relative lowering vapor pressure is equal to the A by M divided by B by W. So it is also P naught minus Ps by P naught is equal to A by M into W by B. So in this equation, P naught is the pure solvent of the vapor pressure. P is the vapor pressure of solution. A is the weight of solute. M is the molecular weight of solute. W is the molecular weight of solvent. B is the weight of solvent. By this formula, we can calculate the determination of molecular weight of solute. Next question is, the question is from D and F block elements. What is ligand? Explain the terms of unidentate ligand, bidentate ligand, polydentate ligand and ambidentate ligands, giving one example of each. First, the definition of ligand. The molecule or ion or atom which can be donated a pair of electron to the central metal ion or atom to form coordinate covalent bond or to form coordination complex compound is called ligand. Types of ligands, which is based on the donor atoms. In this, the first type of ligand name is called unidentate ligand. The ligand which have one donor atom is called unidentate ligand. Example, ammonia, chloride, bromide. These are act as a unidentate ligand. In ammonia, the nitrogen can donate a pair of electrons to the central metal atom or ion. The second type of ligand is the bidentate ligand. The ligand which have two donor atoms is called bidentate ligand. Example, carbonate ion, sulfonate ion, oxalate ions. These are act as a bidentate ligands. The third type of ligand is polydentate ligand. Ligand which have more than one donor atom is called polydentate ligand. Example, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid is act as a polydentate ligand. And the last one is ambidentate ligand. The ligand which can linkage through two different donor atoms is called ambidentate ligand. Example, nitrate ion and thiocyanate ion. In nitrate ion, the coordinate covalent bond is linked through nitrogen and oxygen.